Hey everyone, welcome back to Daily Tuition. In this tutorial, we are creating a simple HTML email template design with Bootstrap. In this video, we are using the latest Bootstrap framework and also use the CSS. This template is responsive for mobile and tablet devices also. So before we start this tutorial, make sure you subscribe us and press the bell icon to get notified of my every new video. And also press the like button if you find anything useful in this video. So as always we say, before we getting late, let's get started. First, we had created a folder responsive email and open it in the code editor. In this folder, we already created a stock folder and put the image inside of this stock folder. We are using this image in this tutorial. So after that, what we will do is we will create a new file index.html and style.css. In index.html file, we simply create HTML5 snippets and change the page title. After that, from the Get Bootstrap website, we will copy this bootstrap.css file CDN and paste it here. And then copy the font awesome icon CDN and paste it here. At the last, we will link our style.css file to custom style. Okay, now we will design our page. In the body, we create a Bootstrap container class, and in this class, we put outer panel, text center, and rounded class. Outer panel is a custom class. Text center is a Bootstrap class to center all the text, and rounded class used to add border radius. So in this class, we insert an icon and add padding too. Then run this project using live server. Live server is an extension you need to install in your Visual Code Editor. So we will right click on the project and select open live server. So this is the icon. In the outer panel, we create inner panel class with rounded Bootstrap class. In this class, we put a row and create a column using callMD12. In this column, we create H6 heading tag with margin top and insert some text here. Then create a paragraph and add some demo text here. After that, we will create a new column and put the image tag. For the source attribute of image tag, we will specify the stock image path here. Then we'll specify the alt text and add style. And specify width and height. So this will look like this. After that, in style.css file, we create a body tag and remove margin and padding from the HTML elements. After that, we will create outer panel class. And specify width 60%. Then specify padding and background color. I am using RGB alpha color to specify the background color. Now we wanted to center this element, so we will create a container class and specify display flex and justify content property center. After that, we will create an inner panel class and specify background color. And box shadow property. Then for the paragraph, we will specify font size. After that, in index.html file, we create another column and insert paragraph with some demo text. So to specify demo text, we will use the Lorem website and copy this text. And paste it here. After that, we will create a button and specify class btn, btn warning. And insert download template text here. Then you can see this button here. Then after the closing row div, we create horizontal row here. After that, we create another row. In this row, we'll create two columns of Bootstrap grade system. After that, we will create a new column using call md2. Inside of this, we will add padding 4 and insert icon. You can choose your own icons from the Font Awesome website. So first, we will specify the name of the icon and then specify the size using FA2X class, and then specify padding Y and padding X. Then create a style for this icon and specify background color. So this icon look like this. After that, we create a second column using call md10 and specify padding 4 to it. In this column, we insert h6 heading tag and insert text. And then add paragraph and insert some demo text here also. So now you will see this design. After that, we will create a new column using call md2 and specify padding x 4 for this column. Then insert the icon here with background color. After that, create a second column of call md10 and specify padding x to it. In this column, insert h6 heading tag with some text and also insert the paragraph with some demo text. Then you will see this type of design here. After that, create a new column using call md12. And specify padding 4. In this column, insert h6 heading tag and specify text. You can choose your own text here, whatever you want. And then create anchor tag and specify your email here. Then we create a style for this paragraph. So we'll specify font size and text decoration property none. That's perfect. After closing inner div, we will create a new row and insert a column inside of this. In this column, we create a footer tag and specify some padding to it. In this footer tag, we create a deflex, flex row and padding x class. Using the flex row class, we will create an HTML element in the single row. So whatever you inserted here will align in a single row. So here we will insert a social icons. So first we will insert Facebook icon with circle class. We create a circle class here to specify some style to these icons. So we will create some icons here. After creating the icon, this will look like this. After that, we insert a paragraph with some demo text. That's it. After that, in style.css file, we will create a button and specify font size. After that, we will create a circle class and specify width 40 pixel, height 40 pixel, border radius 100 pixel, and margin 2%. Then specify border 1 pixel solid and then specify color for the border. Text align, center. And padding top 12 pixel. After that you will see this result. Now your design is ready, but now we need to check it is responsive or not. So we will check that. You will see this project is not completely responsive. Now we will create some code to make this project responsive. So in style.css file, we will create a media query and specify the device width 425 pixel. So here, when you reach to this size of screen, we want to change some classes. So we are changing the style for these specific classes. So here we create outer panel class and specify width 100% like this and padding 3%. After that, we will create a title text class and specify this class to the second title here. And create this class in the media query. So here we will specify padding top So this will look like this. This will add some padding to the top. And after that, we will remove border from the circle class. That's it. Now your template is ready. You will see now this template is fully responsive for mobile and tablet devices. So if you find anything useful in this lesson, then must press the like button. And if you are new on this channel, then press the subscribe button. If you have any question, then you can ask me in the video comment section. That's all for now. We will see you in the next lecture. Till then, be happy and keep watching.